Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel, Alsace. I'm gonna be upfront with you and say that I did not watch Into the Spiderverse. I know, most of y'all think that's the greatest movie to ever exist, ever, and to be honest with you, I'm sure it's just as amazing as you say it is, but like, I just never got around to it. But I'm sure that's all gonna change very shortly, because I just got so motivated to watch this movie, now that I just found out that this man's is going to be in the sequel. For those of you who don't know, on November 1st, 2019, the official Spiderverse Twitter account tweeted this short video. And if you pause this short video right about here, you can see this logo, which may seem like nothing to most people, but for Toku Twitter, this means the absolute world. Because this logo looks exactly like this logo, and this is the logo for Toei's 1978 Tokusatsu adaptation of Spiderman for Japan. The show was called Spiderman! Yeah, that's the first and last time I'm ever gonna call him that. I hated that just as much as you did. But anyone who knows me or my channel is fully aware of the fact that I love the Power Rangers and all things tokusatsu. In particular, I love weird tokusatsu. For me, the stranger and more outlandish the premise, the better. It's the reason why I love going over American toku adaptations on Not the Power Rangers. They're all just so weird and they all have so much personality and charm, and I love them, even though most of these shows are made the worst way they possibly ever could have been. Most of them are trash, but I still love them. But what if I told you that none of this would exist if it wasn't for this man right here? That's right, American toku as we know it would not exist if it was not for Japanese Spider-Man. And here's why. For some background, Japanese Spider-Man was a collaboration between Marvel Comics and Toei Company that aired on Tokyo Channel 12 in 1978. It was very loosely based on the actual comic book character, with the only major differences being that Spider-Man was like a motorcycle racer named Takuya Yamashiro, who's the son of a space archaeologist who was killed after investigating a UFO sighting. Takuya becomes Spider-Man after meeting Garaya, who's the last living person from the planet Spider. Garaya injects him with spider DNA in order to fight off Professor Monster and the Iron Cross. God, I love these names. So clearly it takes some liberties with the Spider-Man formula, especially once you consider the fact that he pilots a giant transforming fucking spaceship, which is Leo Pardon. And he is a major reason as to why this show is so important for modern tokusatsu. Now, I don't know who exactly came up with the idea of giving Spider-Man a giant robot. I found several sources stating that it was Stan Lee himself, but I was never able to really confirm any of them. But I mean, if it was, like, of course. The man's a genius. But Leo Pardon was used as a way for the show to integrate toy advertisements into the actual program itself, something that's super common in modern toku today. What makes this instance so important is that this is one of the first times in which a show's budget was actually impacted by toy sales so heavily. Now, obviously, most kids' shows are meant to market toys, but not to the degree in which this show marketed Leo Pardon. In fact, at one point midway through the show, the whole suit got stolen or wrecked or something, and they just ended up splicing up a bunch of stock footage that they had from previous episodes just so they could have him show up, because the toy sales for this thing was that crazy. This concept of having the characters pilot a giant mecha on television was also integrated into Marvel and Toei's second venture, this being the very first or third or fourth Super Sentai season, being Battle Fever J. The timeline is iffy, because if you were to ask anyone today, they would tell you that Battle Fever J is in fact the third Sentai season. It comes right after Go Ranger and Jacka. But in 1976, Ninja Captor was considered the second Super Sentai season, subsequently making Jacka the third and Battle Fever J the fourth. But in 1988, Liveman was considered Super Sentai's 10th anniversary, because at this point, Super Sentai was airing for 10 years, which would mean that Battle Fever J was the first season. But this all gets changed once we get to 1995, when Go Ranger and Jacko reclaim their roles for the first and second Super Sentai seasons, respectively. But not Ninja Captor, unfortunately. I don't know why. I don't know why they did that to them. But no matter how you slice it, Battle Fever J is indeed a super important Super Sentai season as a whole. This is because of the fact that it's the first season to have a giant fucking robot. Can you tell I love giant robots by now? Battle Fever J was initially thought to be Toei's adaptation of Captain America. And I guess since this was marketed towards Japanese kids, they decided to make it Captain Japan with his companion Miss America. And I guess somewhere down the line, they just said fuck it and made a whole Sentai team. I don't know. And this technically means that the entire Super Sentai universe exists within the Marvel Comics multiverse. I don't really know exactly how the number system works here, but I've seen several sources state that Battle Fever J takes place on Earth 79203. And no matter how you slice it, this was the show that saved Super Sentai, almost, maybe. At this point, Super Sentai was declining in both sales and viewership, like it always is, apparently. But this show was able to bring both of those back with the inclusion of the robot, Battle Fever Robo. This paved the way for the inclusion of mech fights within every single Super Sentai season ever since. It's weird to think that the original Megazord wouldn't exist if it wasn't for the fact that some guy in Japan had the crazy idea to give Spider-Man a giant robot lion friend. It's obvious these robots lead to toy sales, and these toy sales work perfectly for how Haim Saban wanted to integrate Super Sentai into the highly capitalist society of America, baby. And as you know, Power Rangers paved the way for so many other American toku adaptations that I love. Because before Power Rangers, there was no interest in this type of stuff within the Western market. Like, without Power Rangers, we wouldn't have shows like Big Bad Beetleborgs, Superhuman Samurai Syber Squad, or even Tattoo Teenage Fighters from Beverly Hills. What the fuck are up with these names? Plus, if it wasn't for Power Rangers Dino Thunder airing on Jetix in 2004, I would have never been introduced to the genre as a whole. I wouldn't have any reason to care about Sentai or Kamen Rider or even Ultraman in the slightest. And as I said earlier, these are my favorite shows in the world, hands down. I don't like anything more than this, and I genuinely mean that. They're the reason why I wanted to study film as a little kid. It's always been my dream to make my own tokusatsu or tokusatsu adaptation, and I guess I have Stan Lee and Japanese Spider-Man to thank for all of that. Finding out that Spiderman, I know I said I wasn't gonna do it again, but knowing that he's going to be in a mainstream blockbuster film makes my heart literally explode, almost. This is even more sweet considering the fact that Ready Player One didn't include both Leo Pardon or an Ultraman in the film adaptation. Because, I don't know, they're just too nerdy for the fucking nerd movie or something? Toku is like the nerd of nerd culture, like no one understands him and everyone's too afraid to ask why he's like that. But seriously, I'm so excited to see this movie, knowing that as a tokusatsu fan, I can finally have something toku related on the big screen that's meant just for tokusatsu fans, just like me. But yeah, thanks for watching the video. Please be sure to like it if you liked it, dislike if you dislike it, and comment down below any and all thoughts you have on Sentai, tokusatsu, Japanese Spider-Man at all. Be sure to subscribe, hit the bell notification for brand new videos just like this every single Friday. My name's Alsace. Bye-bye.